Come back, still looking at the speculative list, ministerial list of the president that's been sent to DSS. According to newspaper reports, the DSS will be sending the results of the screenings to the president by the end of the week. President, by the way, has left for France, as you well know, to speak with the French, the head of the French government, Hollande. And this reminds me, look, you know, you were speaking earlier about different departments and agencies that also have to be peopled. Remember when the president, so far, the appointments that the president has made, critics have called it lopsided. And we've heard that. Can we just be a bit patient? And when we see a more comprehensive picture, then we'll be able to better make an assessment as to the spread of the thing. I'm reminded that the head that the president chose for customs, for instance, initially he was not so favorably disposed to the idea, but I think it was prevailed upon. And then, having arrived, one of the things that caught my eye was when he was speaking to his new charge, you know, his new buddy. I think he had said inter alia, paraphrasing him now, say, look, you involve yourself in corruption as an officer here. I'm not just going to
sack you,
cause you to be sacked.
I'm going to prosecute and jail you.
I'm going to prosecute and make sure you go to jail.
Yes.
So it's like, this is the kind of person I'm. I was sitting down, JJLA. I didn't even want this job. They went and brought me, but if I'm here, I'm going to do it.
Yes.
That begins to show in that one instance that, oh dear, you know. So that these are, and by and large, you need to see how that particular report was circulated all over the media. It would seem that people are saying, now that's the way it should go.
Yes. Yes. So what do you want to, say to that?
Olawale Balogun.
Yes.
He's calling in from Ajeromi. Good morning, Mr. Balogun.
Good morning, sir. Mr. Yori.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. We are very grateful for God to give us a payment body. Because we try all our best, we pray to God, and God answers our prayer. So please, we should, allow that man to select best for us. One new people. People on the speculative is Palano, so many of them are qualified. We want them, we need one new one. I don't know, I wouldn't say we are tired with these politicians, but by God's grace, those new people will give us what we want.
Yes.
And they can do their best. Mm-hmm. And I thank God that everything is okay by God's grace.
Yes. Thank you. So thank you. Thank you very much for calling in as well. Mm-hmm. I hear you. You know, there's a way in which this keeps on coming back round to the whole issue of corruption. We want people who can do their best, as Mr. Balogun just said. But in addition, so we're talking about efficiency, round pegs in round holes.
Yes.
But in addition, we also want you to be corruption free. I mean, nobody's a saint, because I've seen some critics refer to the officers, the people that are going to be appointed as the search for Buhari's saints. It's nothing like that.
Nobody's a saint.
No, it's not. It's nothing like that, really. But it's just.
But we're talking about.
People want to change.
People who can live above board. People who see public office as an opportunity to impact on the lives of Nigerians, and indeed Nigeria. We want people who will be able to take Nigeria to the next level, to where we belong. You see, the paradox of the Nigerian situation is that we are a country of, although we not really know the exact figure, between 150 and 170 million. And that is to say that for every five blacks in this planet, there's a Nigerian. And Nigeria would need to be, we need to be very conscious of that fact, that a lot of responsibilities are on us as a nation. We cannot afford to fail. Especially this time around. Because if there's economic turmoil in Nigeria, what will happen to Africa?
Yeah.
A country of about 150 to 170 million. Mm. Look at even the little problem in the northeastern part of the country, which is just one-sixth. The population is less than one-sixth of the country. Look at its spiral effect on Cameroon, on Chad, on Niger. And if you now think of, if it now becomes explosive, and there is now cause for refugees, moving out, people moving out.
Yeah.
I mean, just imagine 2 million people or 3 million people leaving Lagos, going to Republic of Benin, going to Togo, going to Ghana.
That would be catastrophic.
And, from the north too, about 5 million people going that way, and in the southeast, about 5 million people go that way.
No, that would be scary. That would be scary.
Look at even what is happening in Europe today.
Exactly. But one moment, please. Sonny has been holding on from Benin City. Good morning, Mr. Sonny. Are you still there?
I'm still there. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Thank you for calling in.
Thank you for the good program. I want to sincerely say that God did not make a mistake for allowing Buhari to come in a time like this. Even though, according to what you have on your screen, that is speculative militarily, I have dreamt of those people before now that the sort of people can work with this administration. Let's set the pace so that when others are coming, they can look at how they can build on whatever structure there's already on ground. But I also want to that issue, disabuse our minds on this issue of the North, East, West, and South. Nigeria problem is bigger than nobody from Southwest or nobody from Southeast. If you look at competency, because if you look at it right from time, of course, the federal character, I encourage things like that. Then those things have been used for a very long time. What has been the result? So if Fela was back to me, I would have preferred someone like Fela and Nkulako to be on that list. If someone like Chief Gani was alive, I would have pleaded that if he should come and study the country. So these are the kind of people that we need right now in Nigeria. It doesn't matter where they are from, but if they can deliver and save Nigeria from this problem, one of your callers said that if you look at what the Indians and the Chinese are doing, they make Nigeria slaves in their own country. I don't think it is a good thing. So we need to look and study the country, study the people, and give us back hope that anywhere Nigeria is not afraid to say that I am in Nigeria. So that's what we need right now for the country. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for calling in.
Yes.
He makes a very...
Let me react to... You see, the basis of talking about foreigners coming to Nigeria to exploit our people, still part of the corruption we're talking about. There are people there, we have enough laws to checkmate the activities of exploiters. But it's just that they look the other way around. And what is the cause? Corruption. Because they've compromised. If people put in positions of authority and not compromising, then we'll not be talking about people abusing our laws. Because we have enough laws. The immigration is there to do their job. The customs are there to do their job. The police are there. I mean, it is only in this country we have multi-dimensional agencies doing the same thing and all over and all over. Since I was a young boy, I've only heard about Metropolitan Police, Scotland Yard. No more, no less. But here we are. Within the last 15 years, for the Nigerian Police Force, Anti-Fraud Unit, EFCC, ICPC, and so many other agencies doing the same thing. And of course, you take people from these agencies to form another agency.
Yes.
Instead of putting all our eggs in one basket and consolidating. Since I was young, I used to know of FBI. It has never changed. You can create units within those agencies. But then, what has changed? It is now perhaps we are seeing some changes coming up and others. But to my mind, those people who are starting with responsibilities, they must for God's sake perform. If they're not willing to perform, they should ship out.
Okay. And then, you know, the caller saying that, look, he didn't really care where people come from.
No,
we have to care.
No, to some extent,
yes.
It might be right, but then we will need...
Yakub, apologies, I'm going to be with you right now.
With the constitution, we have to be taking cognizance of is the grand norm.
Exactly.
It's the grand norm, whether we like it or not. So that's our constitution.
The president must go all around the country. Yakub, please go ahead. Thank you very much for holding on.
Thank you, Chief Yori. And then to your guest.
Thank you.
Chief Yori, I think we are lucky. We are very, very lucky to have this president, Muhammad Buhari. If you can say that, sometimes I do wonder that if country was, and we don't have this place, we have to re-find ourselves now. I think it could have been a bad decision for us. But thank God Almighty Allah, for make our mission be possible. See, I want to correct one impression that my friend, Reverend Dominic, I know he's a friend of this program, likewise me too. He says that he bet his life because none of this conversation is going to come to pass, me being this ministerial on this paper, none of them is going to make it. I dare disagree with him. Because if there is no smoke, there will not be fire. Tibiori, for me, I would be an actual somebody in the head. If come to pass, somebody like Falana make that ministerial list, and then you be Attorney General of this federation, Tibiori, I would be very, very happy. Because it is not a politician, and then it's not going to be biased. Whether you are APC, whether you are PDP, whatever you call yourself, or up there, or whatever. If you call as a corrupt leader, he is going to get it because he will not go to look for money. Like as our president. Look at the vice president. So to say, he declared the total what he has. And then let me add it, finally. If you are anybody, whether you are a politician, whether you are a technocrat, before you are certain this ministerial appointment, you must tell us what you have, your liability. You must let us know. Failure to do that, we don't want to. Thank you.
Thank you very much for calling in, Yakub. Just to say, in case there were any first-time listeners, I am not a chief, but Yakub, he always calls me that.
Who knows? Who knows? The voice of man, the voice of God.
So
Claim it.
Let's get on with the program. But as you were saying, there are imperatives, there are constitutional imperatives relating to the gentleman who thought that, look, can we just not sacrifice anything at the altar of this federal character and just get the most efficient bunch? The truth is, there are efficient, there are correct people, to use the Nigerian word, correct people in any state of this country. It depends on how thoroughly you want to look. I don't believe that any state can have a situation.
From statistics, no state is less than 2 million in population. So if we have a state that has 2 million people,
you should be able to
getting 10 people from that state,
yeah.
even if you are talking about professors or whatever, that every state must be able to produce them. So I think there are many unsung heroes in this country.
Yeah. And it does look. And I think the point that Yakub was making about the kind of person that the persona that Falana has, he's not, even though, as you identified, a clear supporter of APC, but he's not a card-carrying member. And when it comes to the job, if he is considered, one can sort of vouch for Falana.
I can vouch for him.
Yeah.
I can even take a bet.
That the man will just do what he needs to do.
Yes.
You know. Okay. George from Ikeja, good morning, sir.
Good morning, Uncle Yori.
Thank you for calling in.
We can only talk speculatively because the list is not real. I wish it was. But be that as it may, I would be pained to see that Mr. Femi Falana leaves what he's doing now and go into the government, as good as he is. I don't see a replacement. What he's doing is so valuable to Nigeria, more than if he were to be a minister.
But the president is said to be more favorably disposed to Malami, according to the speculation.
He's a minister, not portfolio.
Okay. You're just a minister. Oh, okay.
Yeah. If I have power to make that possible, for him to remain what he's doing now, I will have done that.
Okay.
But be that as it may, Uncle Yore, I think we can sense the direction the president wants to go. He wants to use credible people that he is sure can deliver. I agree with that entirely. I would be very happy to see somebody like Obi Ezekwesili in the Ministry of Education. She needs to go back. She started something there which was revolutionary in nature. And if you give me, if I were the person nominating, I would put her back there. And I would be surprised if the president does not make Fashola a member of his cabinet. I'll be very, very surprised.
How about Amechi?
No, he has a way to I can tell you categorically that Nigeria will lose a lot if Fashola is not used in this cabinet. Thank you.
Thank you very much for calling in. Maybe this is the whole purpose of the speculative list, because the government officials know how to do something they call a controlled leak, in order to gauge. Now we're hearing it. We don't know what the DSS has finished doing, because nobody is about to confirm that. Yep, I actually was invited, but the president will be getting their response by the end of the week. But it's an interesting scenario. Here we are, at least the president's men, if not the president himself, are hearing what people think about certain.
Of course, they are having feelers. They are taking feelers.
That is it. They are taking feelers, and also making some points. George saying
some permutations.
Yes, some permutations, and people saying. I think people are saying that. Yeah, I like the name, like Falana. I'm not sure that I saw be Ezekwesili in there, but I'd like to have her name in there as well. Fashola, we got to have Fashola in there. So all of this is going on. In addition to the list, he's also hearing from the public, and this is as should be, even though Reverend Dominic started off by criticizing the press for causing all this hullabaloo, that they should wait and just report facts. We have to do discussion as well.
He wants news for news. You don't wait for news. And where the news are not even there for you to know about, you must dig into the society within your own environment to sniff something out.
But you can't create something out of nothing. Should there not be anything?
Because of this program, I said, there's no smoke without fire.
Yes. Viewers have also said that.
Where the least we have now might not be authentic, but today is 14. Mm-hmm. I mean, the president has said less than 16 days to fulfill his promise. So something must have been going on.
Indeed.
So perhaps the media is being forced to come up with something that will stimulate the government to act. So if the government is not acting, he now knows that it must act.
Israel, good morning and thank you for calling in. Israel, you were just able to acknowledge and then something happened to your line. So sorry about that. We were saying that the press is actually going about its business.
Yes.
This is
it's the fourth state of the realm.
Yes.
So the job of the media is to bring a discussion to the front burner and for people to be able to make up their minds as to what to actually be done. To stimulate discussions and all that.
It's interesting because, as you pointed out much earlier on in this program, we have to have this list as soon as possible, because you've pointed out that, look, it's not just the cabinet itself, but it also goes into the National Assembly, and when it comes to the State Assembly, to know how to set up.
And the credibility of the government, too, is at stake. You've told the whole world that, look, before the end of September, my list should be ready and all that. So you have less than 16 days to do that.
Yes.
And within that 16 days, we're going to have a public holiday of 2 or 3 or 4 days. And don't forget that the National Assembly will take a break for 1 week for that purpose. The list must be submitted no later than next week.
Okay, no later than this week.
Next week.
Next week, yes.
Yeah.
Mr. Akinyola, good morning. What's going on? Mr. Akinyola was calling in from Badagry. So sorry that we lost that call. But all of those things, Fassi, this break of the Senate, of National... No. I didn't think... Those people will just respond when they're needed. Can they afford not to? Can they be saying that, look, we're on vacation now?
They will go on vacation for Idi Kabir or Idi Alada.
Yes.
They have to go. It's next week. That one is next week. So we are not expecting that much will be done next week. At best, they will sit on. And don't forget, normally they don't sit on Mondays and Fridays.
But couldn't there be special sittings? I mean, here we're talking about fixing our country.
They have committee meetings and all that. Oversight functions. But the proper sitting is always on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays. So I guess the public holiday will be either Thursday and Friday.
So that's shaving off the days. So there are very few days left. If the president is going to meet his promise of September.
That is why it's been speculated that the list might be in batches.
Okay. Victory from Ikeja. Good morning, sir. I beg your pardon. Yaba. Victory, sorry, it's Yaba. I don't know why I put you in Ikeja. Good morning.
Yeah. Good morning, Uncle Yori.
Thank you for calling in.
Good morning to your guest, so that I pass it. Honestly, this issue right now, like there's something Dr. Fassi said that I know, that we are using the one to salvage. But however, in case it does not deliver, see, Nigeria will put so much hope, forgetting that even salvation is not free. That was the price. You know, they pay the price for the salvation. Why Mohammed on the other side? Nigeria needs to sacrifice too as well. Because they can't do everything all alone. The house is there. Nigerians, as individuals, we have to pay the price. We need to sacrifice. So not that we will just wait. Everything will be placed. There will be so much pressure on demand. There's so much pressure on the president. If we all, everything is the president. Everything is the president. The man will be confused.
Yeah.
And that's why it's taking the time to nominate this cabinet.
Okay.
Now the president has brought out the list. However, like Reverend Dominic said, that group was criticizing the Reverend Dominic. And again, I said the reality. Only talk of those of his own period that he could rely much on because he would be able to prove those people's antecedents. But the current crop of politicians, okay, we all know what's going on now. Even an average local government chairman will tell you he wants to make billions overnight. Not to talk of the main government address. That's why they refuse to declare the assets. Because if you have to say in your heart, then
okay.
You will declare the assets.
Victory, what was that point you made about Dr. Fadikwe? I didn't catch the point. The legal practitioner, Dr. Fadikwe.
That he has said it all.
Oh, okay.
That we should expect the unexpected. Then we have to look for another strategy for the unexpected.
Okay. I hear you. Thank you very much for calling in, Victory. Again, that would be in keeping with the Buhari character.
Yes.
If there was just a little, what is soup without a little salt in it? So he just might throw that little salt in there. This is a matter about, you never know how I'm going to make my final decision until I've made it. Yeah, he will be taking counsel, maybe even recommendations, considerations of others. But I suppose looming in everyone's consciousness is going to be the line of look, I belong to everybody and I belong to nobody. In other words, I'm going to call it the way I see it. The president has already demonstrated that. I mean, he's virtually said to his critics, sorry, don't owe anybody an apology. What did you say is wrong? That I have selected people that I can trust and that I can deal with and that need to be rewarded for sticking with me through thick and thin? Sorry.
Not only that, you see, we've not gotten something right in this country. You see, the mentality was still with the mentality of a parliamentary system. But right now, in the last, since 1979, with the interruption of the military, or again since 1999 again, we've been dealing with presidential system of government. See, those people appointed before now are personal staff of the president. So to that extent,
okay.
He has the responsibility of appointing those that he can vouch for. But when I talk about a ministerial list and other constitutionally stated positions, then we need to follow the federal character. And that's what is to be expected. Because he cannot, perhaps under the where we want to reduce the cabinet to maybe to about 15 ministers or 20 ministers, but he has no option, he has to have 36 ministers. Some of them could be junior ministers, so some of them are ministers of state, some will be substantive ministers. Yeah, but he has no option. He has to go around.
Indeed. Well, thank you very much, Fassi. We're going to have to leave it here. I want to thank you for sharing your insights and your perspectives on this matter. Dr. Fassi Yusuf, public affairs analyst and commentator, and God being my strength. I'll be back with you again tomorrow morning at 10:30. I'm Yori Folani. Bye-bye for now.